Welcome to the TIMS Provisioned Users Dashboard Overview. In today's video, we will briefly explore the basic functionality for provisioned LEA users, both certifying officers and superintendents. Let's start with messages. On the left side of the TIMS dashboard at the top, you will find the message queue. Two quick notes about the messaging system. Do not send messages to PDE about applications unless you are specifically trying to request an expedite. Do not request expedites for emergency permits as those applications are already given a priority status. To request an expedite, click Compose New Message. Enter the 7-digit PPID of the educator. Select PDE in the Message To drop-down. Select the application ID for the application that you want to expedite. Note, if no application ID shows, there are no applications available for that educator. Check the PPID to ensure it is correct and follow up with the educator. Select Request for Expedite in the Message Subject drop-down. In the body of the message, list the reasons the expedite is needed. Click Send. The application will automatically be flagged as an expedite and moved to the top of the Ready for Review queue if all required documents have been received. If the application is missing documents, the expedite flag is still set. However, the review will not take place until all of the required documents have been received. Next, we'll look at emergency permit requests. On the left side of the dashboard, at the bottom, you will find the emergency permit request queue. This queue is where you manage all new emergency permit requests and track where they are in the process. All new permit requests come from an educator and are placed in the Submitted by Applicant Type to be Determined column. Note, the emergency permit application process is a two-step process for the LEA. The certifying officer must first view the permit request from an educator and select the details, including the school year, permit type, and subject area. They then submit the response to the superintendent, who must log into their dashboard and sign off before submitting the permit request to PDE. Now let's look at pending criminal charge acknowledgements. On the right side of the dashboard at the top, you will find the pending criminal charge acknowledgements queue. In December of 2018, this new queue was added to the TIMS dashboard in order to notify LEAs when their educators are the subject of pending criminal charges. If a hyperlinked number is showing in the queue, you must click on it and review all educators that are listed. Click the box to the right of the educator, fill in the contact information and your electronic signature and date, read the four statements regarding the Educator Discipline Act, check the box, and click Submit. Note, both the certifying officer and the superintendent must separately acknowledge pending criminal charge alerts. An automated email will be sent daily until all alerts have been acknowledged. Starting in August of 2019, a new requirement was added for superintendents called Mandatory Reporting Information and Acknowledgements. It is only required for the superintendent chief school administrator role. On the right side of the dashboard at the top, just above the pending criminal charge acknowledgements queue, there is a hyperlink. If there is a green check mark next to the hyperlink, it means you have read the information and submitted the acknowledgement already. If there is a red X next to the hyperlink, it means you have not read the information regarding mandatory reporting and acknowledged it. Click the hyperlink and read all of the information. Check the I certify box. Fill in the contact information and your electronic signature. Fill in the date. And click submit. It is recommended that you print a copy of the electronically signed document. When you go back to your dashboard, refresh the screen, and there should now be a green check mark next to the hyperlink. Next, we will talk about the Certifying Officer Affirmation Queue. On the right side of the dashboard, in the middle, you will find the Certifying Officer Affirmations queue. This queue is where you manage all work experience that requires verification. Educators submit various types of applications that require verified work experience, for example, Level 2 or administrative applications. If they enter your LEA in that application, a work experience affirmation is sent to your queue for verification. Note, the work experience affirmation process is a two-step process for the LEA. The certifying officer must first review the work experience affirmation and submit it to the superintendent. The superintendent must then review it and submit it to PDE. Review not started is the queue for new work experience affirmations that have been sent to your LEA. Under review is the queue for work experience affirmations that the certifying officer has started to review and then saved their progress before submitting to the superintendent. Submitted to PDE is the queue for work experience affirmations that have been fully reviewed and submitted by the certifying officer and superintendent. Now let's move to the Chief School Administrator review. On the right side of the dashboard at the bottom, you will find the Chief School Administrator review queue. There are two separate queues. The top one is the Work Experience Affirmation queue, and the bottom one is the Emergency Permit Request queue. As mentioned before, both of these are two-step processes, so these queues are for the superintendent to sign off on work experience affirmations or emergency permit requests and submit them to PDE. While this queue appears on the dashboard of both the certifying officer and the superintendent, only the superintendent role can submit from these queues. So if any of the buttons are grayed out, you may be logged in as the certifying officer and don't have permissions to submit to PDE in that role. That completes the main functionality on your TIMS dashboard. However, I want to quickly highlight two additional features. The first is Search Professional. Along the top in the TIMS heading, click Search, and then select Search Professional from the dropdown. Here, you are able to look up educators to see what certificates they hold. If they are not affiliated with your LEA in their TIMS profile, then you are only able to view the same information that is available on the TIMS public website. If they are affiliated with your LEA in their TIMS profile, then you are able to view more detailed information in their profile, including their contact information and continuing education hours, and you can also print a copy of their certificate. Last, let's look at the export feature. Along the top in the TIMS heading, click export. There are two separate reports available here, the Professional Staff Export and the Employment Availability Export. For this Professional Staff Report, you can either upload a file of all of your staff's PPIDs or choose a file generated from the most recent PIMS staff report. The report is going to load as an Excel file so you can quickly sort your educators and view all of their relevant information. For the Employment Availability Report, you select the credential type and the subject area of the educators you are looking for. You will get a list of educators that hold that certificate that have agreed to be contacted about employment opportunities. That concludes our TIMS dashboard overview. Thanks for watching and keep an eye out for additional videos that will be posted on the TIMS Provisioned User section of our website.